La Asociación Internacional de Estudiantes iniciará su búsqueda anual de nuevos estudiantes. ¿En serio? ¿Qué puede participar? ¿Quiere ser una detective? ¿Qué será antes? ¿Me gustan los concursos? ¿Sabes cuando siga el mayor? Si les interesa participar, más fácil, mi espacio, ya me han encargado de hacer las entrevistas a los candidatos.
Si los resultados son excelentes, podrán ustedes completar. Y la vez, quiero para divertir completamente gratis.
¡Perfecto! ¡Vamos, Alex! ¿Tienes los instrumentos para la entrevista?
Yo no sé si.
¡Vamos! ¡No tenemos nada que perder!
You have a lesson three. You will go to high school. You will have to take a look at that. We will be able to see the effects of the human beings. We can see the human beings. We can see the human beings. We can see the human beings.
Seguro que sí. Pero antes, ¿por qué no nos haces una anterior en la que revisamos el uso de Vicar, Ganter, Granter, para indicar las cosas del futuro?
¿Cuál es el caso de aquí?
I'm going to be a secretary. I want to be an engineer.
I'm going to be a policeman.
No hay bien, porque hoy se viene hablando del futuro. Exacto. Ello de hoy estudiaremos otra manera de indicar el futuro, utilizando el futuro simple que nos ayuda a hacer predicciones. ¿Y cómo podemos hablar del futuro simple? En inglés, el futuro simple se indica con el verbo modal will. Utilizar will es muy sencillo. Pon atención en el futuro de hoy y fíjate. ¿Cuándo se utiliza el verbo modal will? ¡Acompáñanos!
¿Cómo se utiliza el verbo modal will?
Yes. ¿Y el verbo modal will? ¿Y el verbo modal will? ¿Y el verbo
modal will?
¿Cómo se utiliza el verbo modal will? ¿Cómo se utiliza el verbo modal will? ¿Cómo se
utiliza el verbo modal will? ¿Cómo se utiliza el verbo
modal will? ¿Cómo se This person is doing the interview. So, it will be easy.
This is a surprise.
I don't think so. It would be like an 18-year-old girl.
Of course, you don't. Just tell me more like what it was.
Welcome to the Albert Interview Test. Please sit down. This is so exciting. Well, let's begin. I will ask you some questions. I'm going to ask us. Yes, I'm ready.
Very good.
Tell me, what are your plans for the future? Well, I will finish high school, and then I will decide what to study next.
Do you want to get married?
Of course. I will get married someday. But first, I will finish college. has really become the best actress ever. So, you want to marry? Yes. Yeah. I want to be a detective. I want to have a secret. Okay. You see, I live with this. Tell me, after high school, when you come to the study, what are your plans for the future? Yes, I will be in high school. And then, I will go to the university. But you would like to be an actress. More than to become a detective, right? No. I don't know, really. Maybe I will start to become that. I'm not a place, I'm a detective. Do you want to stay here or in another country? I will travel to Australia. Don't have to go back to school. Is there a place? Okay. But the detective association doesn't have schools in Australia. So, you can't study for the detective. Really? I will go to Australia. And then I will come here every week. I can do that. I'm sorry, lady, but I can't accept you. Maybe next year. Okay, maybe you are right. I have to be fair. Thank you for the interview, Stacy. Come in. Hello, Alex. I knew you would come.
Yes. I'm very nervous. I will give you my best
effort. Okay, I do. I will ask you some questions, and you will answer as clear as possible. Ready?
Yes, I'm
ready. Okay, so tell me, Alex, what do you want to do after you finish university?
Well, I will continue working for you. I want to get a degree.
Really? That's great. But you will be very busy.
I will help my family to make enough money.
And I will appreciate that. So, you will finish university and you will get all those kids.
I hope I will work with a reporter. I will continue helping Mr. Bob. Maybe I will choose to be a detective too.
That's a wonderful thing.
I have to take pictures. So, maybe I will make a few of the topics too.
Let's see why you will soon be reversed. You should decide soon.
I feel this is not exactly right. I'd like to help Mr. Bryan with some observations.
I feel very good about that. You can be a photographer at the same time.
Yes. I thought of a talent maybe to be at this school.
That's right. They will teach you how to get every good photograph for investigation.
I know you have good sex in
there. You will be the best. You are now supposed to be the Detective Association School. Congratulations! Come in. Welcome, friends. Please sit down. So, you two want to be detectives, right? Yes. We want to make a better world. Of course.
We're the kids' green eyes.
We need to make a better world. How old are you? I'm 18. I will be 19 next September. Yeah, right. And you're
a boy.
Maybe you didn't sleep well. So, am I going to be Texas Association? Next, the task. First, we will go to the school day. So, some physical training.
I'm
I'm sorry, but if you want to come to me, yes, and you will spend all day in this empty gym. But after all that exercise, we need to take games. No, that's just the first thing. After that, you will have to do community service. And you will clean the defective tools toilets. Finally, I will decide if you are good enough to do the interview. Or, would you make an interview? I'm afraid. So, please, go with this gentleman. I'm looking forward to this time you try to cheat in an interview. Oh, no. I will do anything you want. Please, utilizando el verdadero Will. Y que todo su perfil familiarizada, Will, como el programa de hoy, ya utilizamos para hablar de proyecciones de un futuro basadas en alguna evidencia. El futuro simple sirve para indicar las acciones que haremos en el tiempo posterior. Recuerda atentamente el logo en el que están escritas las letras. ¿Qué tienen en común? Claro, el orden de sus elementos. Recuerda que en inglés es muy fácil. Ya que el orden jamás se altera. Observa. ¿Cuál es el primer elemento? Claro, es el pronombre, nombre, es el efecto de la acción. ¿Y después? Por supuesto, el auxiliar will seguido de un verbo y finalmente un complemento. Por ejemplo, I will go home. ¿Qué idea es? Observa las siguientes oraciones en futuro simple. ¿En qué se parece? Exacto. Todo se configura de la misma manera. Es decir, no se configura de la misma manera para todos los pronombres personales. I will be a doctor. You will be a doctor. He will be a doctor. She will be a doctor. They will be doctors. We will be doctors. Ahora que ya estamos en el uso de futuro simple, hagamos un ejercicio. Aparecerá un verbo y un pronombre personal. Luego, cuando vea la frase incompleta, construiría el futuro simple utilizando estos elementos. No olviden que el verbo con verbo principal siempre permanecen iguales. ¿Están listos? Empezamos. He will be an excellent secretary. For an entire school, he will go to high school. I will go to a university in Canada. They will take an exam next month. When you finish studying, you will get a better job. ¿Pudiste resolver todos los ejercicios? Yo creo que sí. El futuro simple es muy sencillo y muy útil para hablar de las cosas que están por venir. Esto es todo por hoy. Hasta la próxima. Bye. Thank you.